Hey guys, what's going on? Today we're going to be doing a video on the new cards that are coming out on this banner over here. Now, if you haven't checked it out already, I did a full card overview and team building guide of the LR units that are available from this banner. That is the LR Goku and Vegeta. Now, this banner itself also has some non-Dokkan Fest exclusive versions of Vegeta and Goku. These are really awesome units. There's two separate banners and they're available on both of them. So this video, we're going to be going over all four of them. So if we go over here, this is one of the banners over here. This is the one with the Super Vegito. Now, the four units we're talking about is the Vase Form, Goku, and Vegeta. This looks like their first epic fight that they had. This is during the Saiyan Saga. This is Goku using his Kaioken Kamehameha. And this is Vegeta using his Gallic Gun. Then the next one we have is their next epic fight with Majin Vegeta and Super Saiyan Angel Goku. So those are the four cards that we have that are available. I guess, you know, we'll talk a little bit about the banners themselves as well. So the Vegeta banner is not that bad, but okay, look at this. Both banners are really good. You really need to figure out what you want to run. Personally, me, I'm going to be going on the Super Gogeta banner, which is this one, as you see here, literally between the two of them. There's like so much of a difference between the two. It's awesome though. So in terms of overall units and how viable each of the banners are, it really depends on your take and what you're trying to build, right? So on this banner over here, we have Super Vegito, the new Super Vegito, that is. We have Kid Buu, which is a really good 120 lead. The OG Super Saiyan Blue Goku. I'm not saying the right thing at all. Super Saiyan Blue Vegito. So if you don't have the new one, this is awesome for you to have. Plus, it's just cool to have him because of the counters, physical team, and everything. He'll be really good. Actually, it's funny because you have Vegito and Vegito Blue, which is really awesome for a physical team, which you're going to want to have if you didn't see the team building guide already, which you're going to want to have for this guy over here when he's your leader. So they kind of do that a lot when you're looking for a good team building, that you're the guys that you want, like from the Dokkan Fest exclusive. Like for instance, the Super Vegito over here, when you get him, or we'll just call it the Goku and Vegito card, when you have the Goku and Vegito card over here, the intelligence with the intelligence lead, a really good linking buddy is going to be this intelligence Gogeta. So they make it so you want to summon on both banners so you can get all the units that you need. But regardless of that, that Super Vegito, awesome units. Super Vegito Blue is still a really good unit. Buuhan, not so much. If you're going to run a mono intelligence for the Kid Buu team, you're going to want the Kid Buu and the Buuhan because they link very well together. They play very nice. And on this side, we have Janemba. That's it. We have the strength Janembas. So in terms of how viable each of these are, honestly, I personally like this banner better. That's because you have Super Gogeta, you have Super Saiyan 4 Gogeta, and you have the Janembas, which are all really, really good units. I'm not saying that these are bad units, but in terms of units, in terms of viable, in my opinion anyway, Buuhan, Kid Buu, and this Buu over here are not as viable. Yes, there are duplicates of the Super Vegitos that are over there. You might not need them, especially if you have the newest version of Vegito Blue. But I would say the Super Vegito and the Vegito Blue are definitely a lot more viable units for this banner. But you have these three units over here that are not, as opposed to this banner over here, which you have Janemba, which is still a really viable unit in game, and the Gogeta and Super Saiyan 4 Gogeta. Those units are very, very viable and more commonly used. It's up to you. I didn't really want to go too far of a banner review. I already am in about 4 minutes into this video, and I've talked enough about it. But I just wanted to say that that's what I think about it. Now, in terms of these other four units that are over here, we're going to talk about them. We're going to talk about their linking buddies. So let's go ahead and jump into the card review. This is the Tenacious Clash Super Saiyan 2 Goku Angel. Leader ability is Agility Type Ki plus 2, HP, Attack, and Defense plus 70%. So for those of you who are brand new to the game, he's going to be really good for you to help you out, get caught up with everyone else. That leader ability isn't awesome for any of the newer stuff, none of the category leads, and not really a lot of the 120 leads. You might be able to get away with some of the 120 lead events like Super Saiyan 4 Goku. He'll probably come in a little bit handy, but nothing too crazy. But he'd still be a good leader ability for you to have if you don't have anyone else. Super attack is Meteor Blast, greatly raises defense for one turn, causes supreme damage to the enemy. Now, correct me if I'm wrong down in the comments below, I have not seen a greatly raises defense one turn for a super attack. I think that's really awesome. I know it's going to be a mixture because they want to do the opposites between the Goku and the new Majin Vegeta card, but I think it's just cool. Pass a skill acceptable face off. Changes strength key to agility key, which is really cool. I always love type to type. I'm a type to type kind of person when it comes to key orb manipulation, and the next one would be type to rainbow. I hate rainbow to type. That stinks in my opinion. So this is really cool for key orb manipulation. So if you guys are not so new key orb manipulation and you're trying to set something up, he might come in pretty handy for you. Attack plus 12%, recover 5,000 HP per agility key orb obtained. That can come in a lot of handy, very handy. I don't see you, honestly, I really don't see us utilizing him as much as, you know, as other units in game. Newer players maybe, unless you're just going for the nostalgia feature here. I don't see us ever really utilizing him too much, because that passive skill and the super attack is kind of meh. Link skills are Golden Warrior, All in the Family, Super Saiyan, Saiyan Warrior Ace, Prepared for Battle, and Supreme Power. Now, in terms of his Link skills, I mean, he has the generic Super Saiyan stuff, so he'll be good filler for you if you're looking for, units to link with other Super Saiyans. That's really all there is to say about it. You know, he doesn't have anything that sets him apart from anyone else. He is like a year and a half ago's meta. That'd be broken. So probably about a year ago, 6 months to a year ago, average meta card. Now he's just so far gone that I don't see this being a super viable unit to ever be used in game. Again, that's just an opinion in terms of being more efficient when taking on events. He's still a good unit. We didn't really get anything else out of him though. He's part of the Majin Buu Saga and Resurrected Warriors. So maybe if you have something special going on there when you need key orb manipulation, he can come in handy. Max stats are HP of 83-85, attack of 84-22, and defense of 41-28, and a 12 key multiplier of 145%. He has no Dokkan Awakening at this time. So again, I think he is like, I would give him like a B tier, where like, you have your S tier where you're going to definitely run, then you have your subunits for those. If you don't have those subunits, then this guy's probably going to come into play. That's just my opinion on the matter though, so like, don't like hold it to heart, you know. Don't make me upset you if you like it. In terms of his linking abilities with units, these are essentially everyone that he links really well with. This is 4 or more because he didn't have anyone that really linked with 5. This is every single unit in game that he links very well with for 4 or more. Now all these are going to be your generic Super Saiyan links, that's why I said it before. I'm going to go over here and switch it over to agility only, just so we can take a look and see what agility units he links really well with. I'm not going to go too far into team building with these guys, because I don't think a lot of these guys are really that viable. I think it's more for nostalgia purposes. So, honestly, a lot of these are just really support units. This Goku, I still think this Goku is kind of whack. The attack was 70% up at the start of the turn. I don't think that's too viable unless you have anyone else. This guy over here, these two might come in handy because they kind of go hand in hand. Acquired care, so he gets attack plus 15% up. This Gotenks over here, attack plus 15% up for key orb obtained, but that kind of takes away from this Goku's ability because he kind of does the same thing when he gets an attack buff. The only thing over here that I think is kind of decent is this Vegeta. When HP is 80% or less, he gets attack and defense plus 90% up. So this might be the only good unit that he links well with that can kind of be viable. This Gohan is a support unit, key plus 2, attack and defense plus 25% up. So he might be run on a team. And this Goku over here is another support unit for key plus 2, attack plus 20% up when HP is 50% or more. And this is another nuker. So really, in terms of this guy, he really doesn't have that many good links. He's just a generic, bland, thrown out there Super Saiyan Goku. He's cool to have if he's a brand new unit, but unlike any, like a couple other games that I play, when you, like, I would really like for Dokkan Battle to allow you to get Dragon Stones per maxed out unit. So like, you get a unit like this, he's an SSR, right? If you maxed him out, you'd get like maybe 15 Dragon Stones or 5-10 Dragon Stones to get him up to level 100. And then if you, he has a Dokkan Awakening, he would Dokkan Awaken him, max him out to level 120, and you get another like 15 stones. That would be pretty awesome. Unfortunately, we don't have a game mechanic like that, so we can't do something like that, but that would be cool. Outside of that, I don't think he's worth pulling for, but that's my opinion, like specifically for him. Obviously, he's not going to be a primary unit in the banner, but I figure I'll let you know that's my opinion on it. We're going to jump over now to the Majin Vegeta. Clash of Pride Majin Vegeta, his leader ability, strength type key plus 2, HP attack and defense plus 70%. So the same thing as the Goku, his super attack, Dark Impact, greatly raises attack for one turn, causes supreme damage to the enemy. Same thing as Goku, except instead of defense, he's doing attack. Passive skill, Extortion of Confrontation. So he's the exact opposite key or manipulator, agility to strength, and as opposed to strength to agility. Attack and defense plus 12%, so he doesn't have the HP regeneration like Goku does. His is an attack and defense buff per strength key orb obtained. I personally don't find it, I mean, so here's the thing, he has a super attack of greatly raises attack for one turn, which will definitely help increase his attack ability. So he'll definitely do a lot more damage, especially with this nuking ability. He will tank a little bit better too because of that defense buff. But honestly, supreme damage, I don't see him doing a lot of damage. I'd have to take a look and see how much he actually does hit with like maybe 6 or 7 key or strength key orbs in his attack. He might do some decent damage, but I don't think he's going to be a ridiculous amount of damage. He does have some decent link skills. Same thing as the Goku, Super Saiyan, Saiyan Warrior Race, Saiyan Pride, which actually sets him apart a little bit. Royal Lineage over in a Flash, which is another decent one, and Supreme Power. Honestly, it's kind of funny. I feel like they gave him a little bit better treatment in terms of attack damage than the Goku. But, you know, because I feel like it's the duality between the two. They made him strength and the Goku agility. Goku innately will have the agility advantage over him in terms of these two battling. But in terms of card worth between the two of them, I kind of feel like Vegeta got the upper hand on this one because he does a little bit more damage output. He is part of the Majin Buu Saga category and Resurrected Warriors. He might come and play for Resurrected Warriors for you guys, you know, if you want to run that kind of a team. Max stats are HP of 72-17, attack of 89-97, and defense of 39-93. And he has a 12 key multiplier of 145%. I like how they're stepping up the game with 12 key multipliers, throwing them up a little bit higher over 130, because the average was about 130 to 140 for a while. 145, I know it's only a 5% buff from the usual max for a TUR, or for a TUR is usually around 140. The fact that they're giving the SSRs now 145, that's a change in the times, you know what I mean? So in terms of Dokkan Battle Builder, let's go over here and jump into that real quick. Now, this is his best linking buddies in game 4 or more. We can jump this down to 3, but when we jump it down to 3, there's just so many of them. Well, not all, so many, I guess. Essentially, almost all Vegetas and a couple Bardocks, though only one Bardock, maybe. Vegetas, mostly Vegetas, Super Saiyan 3 Gokus, the two Super Saiyan 3 Gokus, and that's probably only because of Over and a Flash, a couple of Trunkses. In terms of viableness, if we're going to talk about a mono strength team, I guess, it's kind of cool for a mono strength team, right? Now, it's difficult to say because he is such a whack character when it comes to linking abilities. Three key links with his Super Saiyan 3 variant for damage reduction. So he'll do pretty good because of his defensive buff that he gets with his key orb manipulation. He's not going to be a primary unit you're going to run in-game, in my opinion, because there's so many other units you can run in place of him. Again, B-tier units. But he at least shares those link skills, and then he has 4 key links with the Super Saiyan 3 Goku. Again, an old-school unit they're probably never going to run, but, you know, you can actually run them. Over on Flash definitely helps this guy out. Honestly, I could see him being a little bit more viable on a mono strength team, extreme strength team, that is. So let's lower this down a little bit, and that's because of the Broly factor. Now, not everyone is lucky enough to have LR Broly and TUR Broly. These two share two key links, and there's not that many STR Super Saiyans. So honestly, in terms of who you could have on a mono extreme team with LR Broly, if you're running a Janemba lead, it's going to be LR Broly, it's going to be Rose, and or TUR Broly. Those are going to be the only Super Saiyans you could have on this team. Having an extreme unit like this on the team is going to help out a little bit because of the fact that you can actually have them linked together. I don't know. That's just my opinion on the matter. I think that it might be a little bit... You might be a little bit hesitant to run him on that team because, again, he's not an amazing unit. But, again, I don't know. Let me know about the damage output down in the comments below. I think he can be viable if you have the proper setup. But, again, I still think he's a B-tier unit. Next one we're going to talk about is going to be the base form Goku and Vegeta. This one is Struggle of Power, Kaioken, Goku. There we go. Sorry about that. Leader skill is Technique Type Key plus 2, HP, Attack, and Defense plus 70%. So they're sticking with the leader abilities across the board. He has the 4-time Kaioken Kamehameha Super Attack. Raises attack and causes supreme damage to the enemy, so he constantly raises his own attack. There's no limit to it. At least it says that there's no limit to it. So he's constantly going to be doing more and more damage. Passive skill, No One Left Behind. Attack and Defense plus 70% when performing a super attack, which is really awesome. When HP is 50% or below, key plus 5 and attack plus 50%. So that's actually that's kind of a broken unit. You know, I actually didn't read any of his abilities until this video. So that's actually a really broken unit. I'm just thinking about it now. If you get below 50% health, you're doing 120% attack buff plus the Kaioken mechanic with supreme damage. Let's see, his attack stat, 8,000 ain't great, but he has a 12 key multiplier of 140%. Actually, what we have, a how does it work section. I'm not going to go through all that right now. 30% attack buff with a 12 key multiplier of 140%. So that's pretty awesome. It's not horrible. It's not great. I think he will do really well over time. Link skills are Z Fighters for attack plus 15%, all in the family. Saiyan Lineage, Kamehameha, Shocking Speed, and Over in a Flash. So he does have some good key links, which is awesome. You always like those key links. In terms of linking ability with partners, the best ones that we have in game for him are four or more. Ultimate Gohan, the Strength Ultimate Gohan. We have the Goku that looks like he came during at some point here. Four key links. I think he is from one of the events. We have the Super Saiyan God Goku and the other physical Ultimate Gohan. So we'll go through those Ultimate Gohans here. So honestly, in terms of viability, I don't see him being too viable for linking buddies. We can go ahead and take a look for a mono technique team if we really want to go down that route. We're going to keep it tech only, TURs. His best, oh look at that, he doesn't do too shabby, I guess. He links well with the Super Saiyan 4 Gogeta. The other unit that he's going to link really well with is this Goku over here, day-to-day study. That's, and the reason why they link together is because this is Goku Kaioken, and this is just regular Goku. Honestly, I don't see you running them again in the B-tier units. Keep that in mind, B-tier units. I don't see us ever running them together, but they do share 5 key links with the 2500 attack buff. So that is there. You can run it if you want to. Again, not my cup of tea personally, but he is a decent unit. I think he would do some decent damage. And overall, it's a cool unit. It's a nice throwback to the Vegeta and Goku fights. So now we're going to jump into talk about Fiery Pride Vegeta. His leader ability is Physical Type Ki plus 2, HP attack and defense plus 70%. His super attack is Gallic Gun, raises defense and causes supreme damage to the enemy. Passive skill is Elite Talent, attack and defense plus 70% when performing a super attack, and when HP falls below 50%, he gets Ki plus 5 and defense plus 50%. So he will be tanking a little bit better when his HP drops, which is awesome. Now, I don't know if that defensive buff, it doesn't say at the start of the turn, so it should be HP reliant. So if you use like a Senzu Bean in the middle of the turn, that defensive buff should technically go away. That raises defense in the super attack. I don't know if it's going to be like a Kaioken mechanic with this defense. It might. I haven't done the research on that. So again, let me know in the comments below if that is the case. Link skills are Super Saiyan, Royal Lineage, Saiyan Pride, Prodigies, Prepared for Battle, and Over 9000. Decent set of link skills, kind of, sort of, not really. You're not going to really use any of them except for maybe Prepared for Battle and Saiyan Pride. Everything else is kind of key. I guess Prodigies is 10%, so that's not horrible. And Over 9000, almost no one has that, so there's no real reason. I mean, again, it's all nostalgia purposes. That's about it. I think these units are really more for collective. And you see in the background Vegeta up top and Goku on the bottom launching his Super Saiyan, his Kamehameha. I said launching his Super Saiyan. Wow, what a pleb. Max stats are HP of 7028, attack of 7747, and defense of 3803, and a 12 key multiplier of 140%. Now this is cool because this Vegeta can be increased his super attack with the strike event of Vegeta. Actually, this Goku could also have his attack increased with one of the other Gokus that are coming from the epic battle event. It's a rare though, so it's a pain in the butt. And you're almost going to never have an increase, and that's about it. Majin Vegeta doesn't have a farmable unit, and Super Saiyan 2 Goku Angel does not have a farmable unit, if I remember correctly. But let's go ahead and finish up with the team building guide, or the best linking buddy guide for the Vegeta. Best ones are himself, the Super Saiyan God variants. He has 4 link skills, combat ethic Saiyan, which is 700 attack, which is really, you know, useless. Genius, the King of the Lineage or Saiyan Lineage, and Prepared for Battle. So honestly, attack percent plus 10% is honestly all he really has, and the same thing with this one. Outside of that, he doesn't really have any other good real linking buddies. I guess we can go over here, lower this down to 3, and his other best linking buddy is going to be his physical variant, which is the same thing, 3 key links. Yay! Awesome. Anyway, that's about it. Again, these are all like B tier units. You probably won't ever run any of these on a primary team unless you're just trying to have a little bit of fun. I just think they're more for fodder in the banner, so that way you have reasons to pull different cards, more for collective purposes. People who want them are typically just going to do it for collective purposes. If you are a brand new player, I could see them being sort of useful with their leader abilities until you get better units. Outside of that, honestly, I still think they are B-tier units. If you guys like them, don't let me deter you from wanting them. I mean, nostalgia purposes, or if you just think they're good units, it's great for you. Good on you for wanting them. I just don't find them really useful or that viable. But again, it's just my opinion on the matter. But anyway, guys, thank you for joining me here today. I hope you enjoyed that overview of all the four filler cards in this banner. I hope you enjoyed the team, well, the linking buddy guide that I put alongside them. I tried to do a different format this time to add to the video. But anyway, guys, thank you for joining me here today. Let me know in the comments below of these four, which one is your favorite one. Make sure to subscribe if you're new. I'll catch you all later. Peace.